Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Having now been introduced to comments, I didn't want to leave this section without discussing or introducing the idea of docstrings. In actual fact, we have already seen an example of docstrings in the Django codebase in GitHub. Here below this class, we have the triple quotes, start, end, and inside we have a comment. If we inspect what has been written here, we can see that it is describing the purpose of this class. In the second line here, it describes what the class does. So that provides a good template, what the class or what the function is for and what it does. So let's utilize this format to provide some examples later on in this tutorial. There are three characteristics which stand out, which describe the Python docstrings. First of all, the Python docstring is actual fact a string literal. We'll explain that later on in the tutorial. Used after the definition of a function, method, class, or module. So we've just seen it there in the Django codebase, used after a class, but we will provide an example here of utilizing after a function. And last of all, it provides a convenient way of associating documentation with Python code. So in the next tutorial, we're going to see that we can utilize these docstrings to generate documentation. So let's go back to our codebase that we've generated in the last section of this course. I've started a new virtual environment and I've opened up the new app here and I'm looking at the views. Although we haven't fully described or introduced the function yet, we have generated our first function and we can see the format of this function utilizing the def keyword and then the name of the function. So let's go ahead now and generate a docstring. So here we're going to place it underneath the name of this function here, underneath the first line of this function. So we need start and end. So inside of here, we can then generate a comment. So let's use the Django documentation as an example here. We're going to first of all describe what the function is for and then what it does. So what the function is for, this function responds to website root HTTP requests. And then what it does, I've described this as returns index.html template, no database data returned. So that gives us some additional context to this function. We now know what it's for and then what it does. As you start to write more comments and docstrings, you'll start to feel the burn a little bit and potentially notice that there is a real skill here in trying to identify and create sentences that are short, sharp, to the point. You will over time become much more familiarized and obviously experience will take over and that will speed up the time it takes to generate these docstrings. But do remember, like we mentioned earlier, don't spend more time creating comments and docstrings than writing the code. So although I'm only showing one example here, there will be many more examples as we move through this course.